Vitamath 22. Show that the area of a triangle is area sub t equals r sub r times s, where r is the radius of the circle inscribed in the triangle and s is half the perimeter of the triangle. So, I knew that some of you, if not most of you, know this already. But here is the derivation. So this is the triangle in general and the circle inscribed in a triangle. And the radius is perpendicular to the side at the point of tangency. So let's call the center of the inscribed circle as O and the radius as R as shown. Perpendicular to the sides of the triangle. So area of the triangle is 1/2 base times height. So it is equal to area of triangle BCO plus area of triangle, so that's BCO, plus area of triangle ACO plus area of the remaining triangle, which is ABO. And the area of triangle BCO, BCO is 1/2 base, which is A, height, which is perpendicular to the base, R. So 1/2 AR. Then the area of ACO is 1/2 B times R. And the area of the remaining triangle is 1/2 C times R. R over 2 is common, so let's factor it out. So R over 2 times the quantity A plus B plus C. And since A plus B plus C is the perimeter, the sum of the sides of the triangle, divide it by 2, so it is half the perimeter as defined here for S. Therefore, the area is R times S, where S is defined as 1/2 of quantity A plus B plus C. So that's for the first part. For the second part, what is the ratio between the area of a circle circumscribing an equilateral triangle to the area of the circle inscribed in the equilateral triangle? So to help analyze the situation, let's have an equilateral triangle. And it is inscribed in a circle, big circle, and we also have a circle inscribed in the equilateral triangle. The radius of the circle circumscribing the equilateral triangle, let's call it big R, and that is from the vertex to the center of this small circle here, which is also the center of the centroid of the equilateral triangle, which is also the center of the big circle. So in other words, the center of the inscribed circle, we call that in center. The center of the circumscribing circle, we call that circumcircle. And the centroid of the equilateral triangle all lie at one point. And therefore, from this center to the side, perpendicular to the side, that's the radius of the inscribed circle, small r. And since this is an equilateral triangle, this big R here bisects the angle, originally 60 degrees, so that's 30 degrees. So the area, ratio of area is pi big R square over pi small r square. Canceling out pi, so it reduces to quantity big R over small r square. And from this right triangle here, let's define sine of 30 degrees, which is opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite is small r, hypotenuse is big R. So sine 30 degrees, which is 1/2, equals small r over big R. Since this is 1/2, 1/2 equals small r over big R, so big R over small r is equal to 2. Big R over small r is equal to 2. Therefore, the ratio is 2 square. So, ratio is equal to 2 quantity square, and therefore, the required ratio is 4. Of course, I will not leave this video without your part, and your part is this. What is the ratio between the area of the equilateral triangle, the area of this equilateral triangle, and the area of the inscribed circle? Then, how about the ratio between the area of the circumscribing circle, this one, and the area of the equilateral triangle? So that is your part exercise so that you can participate and to make sure that you learn from my videos. So show that the ratio for the first part, the answer is 3 square root of 3 over pi, and for the second part, 4 pi square root of 3 over 9. That might be a problem or a question in one of your subjects.